Seventh day, the first Lord's Day, second decade in the 21st century.
Lord have mercy.
Sin bitten and frostbitten.
Lord have mercy.
We are subject to both, no matter whether we are in Central Florida or Cleveland, Ohio. Last Thursday in Orlando, the temp had not been that low since January 2014. Yeah, Pastor, you know. Just what does it have to do with the subject of your screed? Well, family, I knew I would be asked to get to the point of this screed, so I will. Number one, both sin and cross are alarmingly damaging. Number two, the damage is done for when realizes either is present. And three, it seems uncomfortable and inconvenient to take precaution. Here's what research reveals. Frostbite, the first stage of frostbite, doesn't cause permanent damage to the skin. You can treat very mild frostbite with first aid measures, including rewarming your skin. All other frostbite requires medical attention because it can damage skin, tissues, muscles, and bones. Possible complications of severe frostbite include infection and nerve damage. A, like sin, it shows up and without treatment can affect your mind. Like sin, there's specific treatment required, not just a band-aid or a aspirin. The Holy Writ warns us of the pitiful result of sinful practices. I've termed sin creep. As seen in 1 Kings 15:3, we are sin-bitten when we are not wholeheartedly devoted to God. 1 John 3:4 says, "No one who lives deeply in Christ makes you practice of sin. All have sinned, but do not allow yourself to practice the sin." Please don't consider this to be mean, as I flee from sin in 2018. I climb without a rest stop the very tippy top of the Almighty Rock. Lord have mercy, God, I'm right here.